handsome, taking great care. I like that guy. He's charming. So, Dynamic Taru is there. With weapon, lucky in love. Oh my god, do you see the pants? Oh my god, oh my god. Oh, he's got hit by another Lalafell. LOL! They prepared that. That was really insane. Great job there.
What is up, team, and welcome to episode 3 of Tank Academy. Today's topic is about how to generate snap aggro. We'll be covering generating planned snap aggro, generating unplanned snap aggro, a quick look at the Reddit enmity values for tanks, and the goals of this episode are to know how to generate snap aggro in various situations, and know which skills generate the most aggro with numerical values. So what is snap aggro? Simply put, snap aggro is generating the most amount of enmity in a small window of time. It can be used in two categories, planned and unplanned. Planned snap aggro can happen in the following situations or ones similar to it. A predictable add that spawns in a boss fight and a predictable aggro reset in a boss fight. This basically means that you know when a new monster or an aggro reset is going to appear in a boss fight and can plan for it accordingly. For this type of snap aggro, I recommend the second GCD of your enmity combo before finishing the snap aggro with your third combo GCD. This means you are doing a 2 GCD planned snap aggro combo. I recommend the following setups for each tank class in order to best ensure this. Warrior, School Sunder into Butcher's Block. Paladin, Savage Blade into Rage of Halone, and Dark Knight, Spinning Slash into Power Slash. These snap aggro combos use a second GCD in the enmity combo chain, giving you the initial hit of enmity for one GCD before following it up with the final part of the combo, thus giving you a large amount of enmity within a 2 GCD time frame. Unplanned snap aggro can happen in the following situation. The main tank suddenly dies or disconnects and you are not second on aggro. Situations like this can happen a fair bit, not only in progression but in farm parties too. The number one priority here is to get the attention of the boss in order to save your team to progress forward. For this, I recommend the following two GCD setups for each tank class. Warrior, Provoke, Overpower, Defiance, Overpower. Paladin, Provoke, Flash, Flash, Shield Oath. Dark Knight, Provoke, Unleash, Unleash, Grit. Your goal here is to secure the team's safety by first getting initial aggro and then going into your tank stance to further enhance your aggro with normal rotations whilst allowing your healers to recover. So, can you still keep damage up time with non-aggro combos? Well, the basic answer I can give is this. I always recommend tanks make heavy use of their tank stance when progressing a fight for the first few attempts. This includes picking up new adds that appear on the map throughout multiple phases, or diving into new progression territory. The further you progress, and the more you repeat the progression, you can then start to optimize areas of aggro via damage stance and party enmity skills such as Shirk, Shadeworker, etc. Basically, walk before you can run. On a final note, I'd like to reference the Reddit enmity chart as the main go-to point for current enmity values. These have been worked out and visualized in a numerical fashion and what I have based my rotations on in regards to generating high aggro in shorter time frames. Every tank should have this bookmarked. Well, that's all I got today, guys, so if you have any questions or comments about this topic, then please leave a comment below the video. For now, I am out.